Would everyone please stand and remain standing until all the graduates are seated? Melissa Bell. Tiffany Collier. Crystal Dice. Did I come? Melissa Holt. Heidi Rachels. Chantrell Sapp. April Turner.
Please be seated. Welcome. We're all extremely pleased to be standing here tonight, sharing this moment of accomplishment with our beloved family, friends, and mentors. I offer to speak for our class in an attempt to put into words the experience that was this last year. Unfortunately, there is no one movie that portrays our stories. Put that in there for you guys. As each of us has had a different road that's led us to this moment. Since we're all mothers, we'd like to tell our children. How much we love and miss them. Your time without us will be far made up for in the mother that you will have moving forward. A mother who sacrificed beyond understanding to better herself, to ensure the security of her family, and to show what can be done if you want something bad enough. We're also friends who have had to vent and lean on our closest at times, get out our frustrations in the safety net of their presence. And to my closest friend, who herself has just completed her long-awaited RN. You are what we strive to be in both nursing and friendship. We are wives and partners who would like to thank the men who have had held strong, shown unwavering support, challenged us every day, and in my case has been my rock and inspiration for going after my dreams. Life will soon be better than ever. And to our teachers, I called you our mentors earlier because as a teacher I know how much more you gave of yourself, how much you care, and how important making us aware of our responsibilities as a nurse is. And each one of you gave us something so special. The strength we see in your beautifully unique qualities created an atmosphere that has allowed us to learn who we can be as a nurse without losing who we are as individuals. Thank you. And to my classmates, truly congratulations. We have been through some tough times together, seen each other at our most vulnerable, picked each other up, fed each other things that had no nutritional value whatsoever. Kept track of how many we could get wrong and still make a passing grade. I love each of you. I want to thank you for your friendship. And let us continue on in our adventure as nurses, knowing that there is always this group from the beginning who will tell it like it is. And I promise not to go on forever, so again, welcome and thank you for being here tonight, and please join us in prayer.
Let us pray. Our most graciously Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us all here tonight. We ask you to be with us graduates as we start a new beginning in our lives. Father, we express our gratitude to all that has helped us over the past 12 months. We owe a special thank you to our friends, family, and most of all, our instructors. Without all of their love, support, and guidance, we would not have been able to make it this far. Thank you for allowing us to follow our dreams, and please watch over us as we begin this next chapter of our lives. In your precious Son's name we pray. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Angie Headley. I had the honor of teaching these young ladies. It was a unique experience. Something, I'm not sure yet if it was a blessing or a curse of some sort, or sometimes I looked around and wondered if I was being punked. Because for some reason, I had these students longer than any other students I have ever had. Now, not meaning that they made a bad grade or something and had to stay, it was just the way that the schedule worked out. We rotate our classes, and the faculty here, we gladly share the love among the students. But something happened that semester, and I got to have these ladies the entire semester. Now, when it came time for them to get ready for this ceremony, they came to me and they said, "Miss Headley, give us some tips," because they knew that I was kind of in charge of the one last semester. And they said, "Tell us what we need to do." And I was giving them hints. You need to find a song to walk in on, to walk out on. You need to make a slideshow. And I said, "You have to have a speaker." And they said, "A speaker?" And I said, "Yeah, you know, somebody to come in and give an inspirational speech and talk about how wonderful nursing is and talk about how wonderful you are and how wonderful the world is." And they said, "Well, we don't want anybody to come in to do that. We want somebody to come in that knows us and will talk about us, that knows us as good as you do." And I said, "Well, you know, that could be a good thing and a bad thing." And I was thinking about how I was going to do this. And one time, Kathy Holt, one of our fellow faculty members, the way she handled it, she said that she thought of one word. She thought of the student. She thought of one word that would describe that student. And then she elaborated on that. And I thought, well, you know, that's a good idea. I might try that. Then I heard that for the first time, again, another blessing, I'm sure, on my part, the first time this has ever been videoed. So the words that I had thought of and I was going to elaborate on, I feel sure does not need to be on YouTube, as I heard that this was going to be for our Southeastern Technical College YouTube site. So I've had to kind of back up and punt and think about this. Now, don't get me wrong. I am absolutely thrilled to have been part of these ladies' journey. They are a wonderful group, and I am blessed to have been part of this. Now, there are certain things that happen in their nursing program, and I tell them there's things that's going to happen to them in their program and in their clinical experience that they will never, ever forget. And there are things that happen that I have not let them forget. I told them from the get-go, you know, when people say,
Angie, what do you do for a living? And I said, well, I'm a teacher. And they said, oh, that's nice. That's nice. What grade do you teach? I said, well, I teach adults. And they said, oh. And then they think, well, you know, how hard can that be? They're adults. They're grown. They're mature. They know how to follow instructions. They know how to follow rules. Not necessarily. I told them from day one that I understand that they're adults, that they are used to doing as they like to do, that they make their own decisions, that they eat when they want to eat. They get up in the morning when they want to get up. And I told them all that was going to change. That now, being a student at Southeastern Technical College and in nursing fundamentals class and drug calculations, that they were going to have to do what I said. They didn't take that very well, especially this one on the end, which I'm fixing to start with her. I told them at the beginning that they needed to all get along, that they were going to spend more time with this bunch than they would their families, because they were here at this school with me all day, and any time that they had at home, they were studying. So they would have to ask forgiveness from their family, like starting tonight, okay? Because they were going to be under the control and the influence of Southeastern Tech. They said no problem, they could get along. No problem, they could follow the rules. Y'all just don't know how funny that just really struck a chord in me, okay? Melissa Bell. And one of the tricks about faculty members, and y'all just have to understand this, you know, they take the core classes before they come into the nursing program. So, of course, I get a heads up and a little kind of synopsis of the student before they get to me. So I knew a little something about everybody except Heidi because she was a transfer, okay? I knew something, a little something about all of them, okay? I heard about Melissa Bell before she came. I thought I was ready. If I've ever been challenged as an instructor, it was this one. Yeah, now you do. Okay. One of the big rules, not just in my classroom, through the entire school, you are not supposed to have a cell phone. She's probably got it now, right? Okay. You are not supposed to have a cell phone. It's written in their handbook. It's on their syllabus. It's on signs in the classroom. It's on signs in the halls of the school. You would think that wouldn't be hard to figure out. So one day I walk into the classroom. She's got her phone out. She's playing Words with Friends. I said, Melissa Bell, you're not supposed to have a cell phone in here. Oh, but I'm not using it as a phone. I'm playing a game. I said, Melissa Bell, put the cell phone up. Probably not long, probably the next day, okay? I'm giving this powerful, inspirational lecture, you know, full of information and knowledge. And I look up, Melissa Bell, just as pretty, picks up her cell phone and sits it on the desk. I said, Melissa Bell, you can't have a cell phone in here. Oh, but I'm not using it as a cell phone. I'm using it as a tape recorder. I said, Melissa Bell, you cannot have a cell phone in this classroom. Do you remember what you asked me next? What if I put it on airplane mode? even know what airplane mode means. I said, Melissa Bell, you can't have a cell phone. She finally got the message. It took several episodes and several chats in the office with me. And y'all saw how quickly she teared up here, okay? All it takes is one step into my office and, yeah, it starts again, okay? I told her, I said, Melissa Bell, I said, I'm gonna kick you out of the program. And she just got this look on her face like you wouldn't believe. She said, you can't do that. I said, oh, yes, I can. And after that, I think she got the message, okay? And she behaved herself from then on, that I know of now, that I know of, okay? Now, this next one, I do owe her an apology. There is something about this girl, and I just met her mother, and you should have named her Crystal. Yeah. Okay? I called her Crystal the entire semester. I have a Crystal. The one next to her is Crystal. And I would say something about Crystal, be looking at Tiffany here, okay? She wouldn't look up at me. And I said, well, she might think I'm talking to the other Crystal, okay? So I told him, I said, well, I came up with a system here. I said, you'll be Crystal with a C and she'll be Crystal with a K. And I said, when I'm talking to you, I'll say Crystal with a C, and then when I talk the other Crystal, I'll say Crystal with a K. She didn't say anything. She just, okay. And finally it dawned on me, I said, why is she agreeing with me? Her name's Tiffany. But I know why she agreed with me. Tiffany and I kind of butted horns right off the bat, okay? Tiffany was one of those adults that just thought she could follow the rules, okay? Wanted to, she really wanted to, okay? But she didn't think it was quite cool enough to follow the rules. She's the diva in the classroom, by the way, okay? So Crystal and I kind of butted horns off the bat. I mean, I met Tiffany. I am sorry. See, I'm sorry. Tiffany. I'm going to get you a name tag or something. Tiffany. Okay? And I was fussing about something in the classroom, and it was directed towards Tiffany. And Tiffany made the comment. She said, that's okay. If Miss Headley wants to play, I'll play. And I said, okay. But I knew what she meant. This program was so important to her that she was going to do whatever it took to do what she had to do and get through this program. If it was me calling her Crystal the whole semester, hey, she was willing to do it. Okay? Now, another thing about Tiffany, I had him in the lab. She knows what's coming. I had him in the lab. We were practicing patient transfers. We were practicing going from a wheelchair to a bedside toilet, okay? This is not a glamorous class that I teach, okay? So we're practicing, we're doing our good skills, and Tiffany says, Miss Headley, why are we learning this? So I go into my, well, it's for safety reasons. We have to learn the proper body mechanics so we won't get hurt when we're transferring these patients. She said, no, that's not what I mean. She said, why are we learning this? And I said, I don't understand. She said, well, won't I delegate this to the lower people working under me? I said, no, you didn't, girl. Oh, my goodness. So she has been the delegation queen the whole semester. And another story, now I did not witness this. I wish that I would have. I did not witness this, but I heard, you know, things get around, okay? I heard about Tiffany checking a blood sugar at clinical. Oh, she was so careful. She was going through the proper steps, the proper procedures and all. And she went down and she checked the woman's blood sugar. And she asked the lady, she said, "Did that hurt?" And the lady said, "No, it didn't hurt me a bit." And Tiffany said, "Well, it hurt me because I stabbed myself." And she stabbed herself instead of stabbing the patient. Oh, my goodness. I didn't get to see that, but I wish I would have. Very smart girl. And like I said, she was willing to do whatever she needed to do to get through this program, and she did. My real Crystal, next. And she does spell it with a K. It's Crystal with a K. This is, let's see. This is my worry wart, for one thing. She could not pay attention in class, pay attention to the lectures that I was given, because she was already worried about the test that was coming up. She would work herself in such a tizzy, you just wouldn't believe it. You're talking about tears. Now this one flows like a fountain. She is absolutely the sweetest, kindest, most compassionate person you will ever meet. Very smart, see? I told you. Very capable, but always just had that little bit of doubt about her. Now, how did you do on the exit exam? Awesome, right? See, I just can't.
Yes.
You did awesome. Very sweet girl. Next to her is Melissa Holt. There's something about her name. I couldn't call her just Melissa. It had to be Melissa Holt. Melissa Holt's my quiet one. Quiet. Never said anything. Always made all the best grades on the test. Somebody asked me one time, we were talking about what we wanted, you know, what we wanted for a birthday or something. I said, "I want a classroom full of Melissa Holtz." Excellent student, excellent. But let me tell you, I talked about them not getting along. Now, remember, this is adult learners. Adult learners, okay? I had to separate this class. I had to assign seats in this class to keep them from fighting. I had to spread them from one corner over here to over here. It was nonstop, okay? Melissa Holt never started anything, okay? Because I'm fixing to jump to the instigator. Okay? Not Heidi, but to tell this story, I have to go to the beginning of it, okay? We're going to skip Heidi, the little tiny one there trying to hide. Her name is Chantrell, but we call her Chantel. Quiet, another quiet one, sat in the back corner. Always wrapped up in a big jacket. I'm cold, it's cold in here. Sit back there with arms crossed, wouldn't say anything. We'd be having a good discussion in the class. What happens? Now, when I say who you are, I want you to raise your hand so they'll know who I'm talking about. Chantrell does that. Has not participated in the conversation at all. No input whatsoever. Miss Headley, I got a question. Then what happens? April. Oh, I'm sorry, next, that one, Melissa Bell. Before I can get it out, Melissa Bell whips around, because I had her up front by me. She whips around, answers the question. April. She didn't ask you, she asked Miss Headley. Then we go to Heidi. Heidi's the mama of the family. I call it a family because we are a family. She's not only their mama, she was my mama. Okay? She kept us all straight. Heidi tries to change the subject. Heidi starts telling us about the next animal that Ethan has gotten. He's had every creature made by God to raise there in Wadley, Georgia. Okay? So she tries to calm everybody down, changes the subject, talks about Ethan. Okay? Look over there at Melissa Holt. Melissa Holt never says anything. Her face is just as red as this shirt. She looks like she's gonna explode. And her hands are doing this. And she sits there, she just never says a word. I told her the only two times that I saw her show emotion is when we talked about, I have to teach him about death and dying, and that's sad for all of us, and oh, we're just like, just blubbering in there, okay? When I taught death and dying, and when she read 50 Shades of Grey. Only two times I've seen her show emotion. I hadn't read it. She told me about it, but I hadn't read it yet. I'm scared to. Going back to Heidi, like I said, Heidi's the mama. When everybody was behaving, Heidi was up there close to me. They all had to put up with my hot flashes. I had a little fan that had to blow right on me. Okay, Chantrell's back there in the back with a big coat on. Okay, I'm up there burning up, got a fan blowing right on me, looking for my reading glasses. I swear I had 10 pair of reading glasses, but anytime I needed them up there, they weren't there. I finally gave a pair to Heidi. I said, Heidi, when you see me doing this, hand me my glasses. And she did. She took care of all of us. Very, very kind, sweet, loving woman. She's our mama. I told y'all about little skinny Chantrell. Okay? And I finally figured out Chantrell. Well, it just seemed like she was angry all the time, and now I know why. Okay? Her part-time job was customer service at Walmart in Statesboro. That's what she did on the weekends before she came to nursing school. God bless her heart, no wonder. And April. My April. Now, I did hear a story that I didn't witness at clinical, but I'm not going to share that one. You had a wardrobe malfunction, I heard, at clinical, so we're not going to. Okay. All right. April is probably the, on the outside, the strongest personality that I had in the classroom. You've heard of those people that whatever comes up, comes out? That's April. Very tough, very determined. She told me how important this was to her. She told me, I mean, it wasn't an option. I have to do this. I have to get through this program. I have to do this. And she meant she has to do this for her family. And she was determined to get it done, and she did. She had a lot of bumps in the road. We shed a lot of tears in the office. I had to do a lot of calm down talks. She asked me for some advice. I gave it to her. She didn't listen. But a very, very sweet, determined girl. I'm going to take the fact that I had these students longer than any other students that I've ever had as a blessing. I truly enjoyed every minute with them. I enjoyed teaching them. I hope I taught them something. And it's been an honor to have them, and I am very, very proud. Now, I'm going to read a little poem. I'm not going to look at you. Because you know what will happen. Okay. I wish you enough sun to keep your attitude bright. I wish you enough rain to appreciate the sun. I wish you enough happiness to keep your spirit alive. I wish you enough pain so that the smallest joys in life appear much bigger. I wish you enough gain to satisfy your wanting. I wish you enough loss to appreciate all that you possess. I wish you enough hellos to get you through your final goodbye. I love all of y'all. I'm proud of you.
Summer birds too swiftly flown away. I've never been the one to raise my hand. That was not me, and now that's who I am. Because of you, I am standing tall. My heart is full of endless gratitude. You were the one, to guide me through. Now I can see, and I believe it's only just beginning. This is what we dreamed about. Is all I need to know. I've learned to love myself in spite of me, and I've learned to walk the road that I believe. But the only question with me now is, do I make you proud? Stronger than
imagine this, they leave the mama to speak. When I walked in the classroom on January 9th, I didn't know a soul. Didn't know not one of them. Never seen them. Didn't know the instructors. I was scared to death. Little did I know that I would gain 7 new family members, well, 6, and then 3 wonderful instructors. We never knew what we were getting ourselves into, but we managed. We cried a lot, we laughed a lot, we cried a lot more, but we managed. You will never know what y'all mean to us as instructors. Y'all have taught us things that we didn't know we could learn, and we're truly grateful. Okay, somebody else?
Melissa Bell. Tiffany Kyler. Crystal Dice. Melissa Holt. Heidi Rachels. Chantrell Sapp. April Turner.
Now the graduates will recite the Florence Nightingale Pledge.
I solemnly pledge myself before God and in the presence of this assembly to pass my life in purity and to practice my profession faithfully. I will abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous and will not take or knowingly administer any harmful drug. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession and will hold with confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and all family affairs coming to my knowledge and practice of my calling. With loyalty will I endeavor to aid the physician in his work and devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care.
And now it's my pleasure to present to all of you the Southeastern Technical College Fall 2012 Nursing Graduates. We are very proud of them.
To my life, for all the wrong that you made right.